In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create subtitles inside Premiere Pro by using the auto transcribe features built into the software. Whether you're creating subtitles for short vertical videos, or maybe you're creating closed captions for YouTube or other online videos or broadcasts, I'm going to cover everything in this video. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
So the first step before we dive in and start creating subtitles is to actually have Premiere Pro automatically transcribe our audio clips for us. So with Premiere Pro open, what I'm going to do is go up to Premiere Pro Preferences, and you should see an option called Transcription. When we click on this, you'll notice that we have some options here. The first box is to automatically transcribe our clips. So make sure that's selected. And then underneath that, you have two options. You can auto-transcribe all imported clips, or the one I prefer, which is auto-transcribe only clips in the sequence. This means when you add audio clips to the sequence, it'll only then transcribe it. That way, Premiere Pro isn't working twice as hard trying to transcribe everything imported. Maybe you're not going to use some clips. That's why I usually select this option. Then down below, you have separate speakers and then different transcription language options as well. Once you have that set, you can click OK. And you can continue creating your Premiere Pro project. Now, in this example, I'm going to open up a Premiere Pro project that I've already worked on just to show you how to work with captions and transcriptions. So before we go any further, I do want to illustrate how Premiere Pro auto transcribes audio clips. So let's actually import some audio. So I'm going to go find some audio and import it into my project. If I just select this audio here and import it, you'll notice that it doesn't automatically transcribe because we told Premiere Pro to only transcribe it when it's added to the sequence. So say if we click and drag this to a new sequence, you'll then notice at the top right this little progress bar. When we click on it, you can see that Premiere Pro is now transcribing this audio clip only when it's added to this new sequence here. So that's how it automatically does it. So as soon as you click and drag audio clips to your sequence, it'll then transcribe it. You can also see this in the text panel as well. If you go to Window Text, you can see that it's now trying to transcribe it. And then once it's done, it'll auto-populate all of the transcribed language inside this panel here. But once it's done, it should look something like this. You should be able to see your transcribed video. And one of the cool things is that you can click in here to jump forward in the playhead to different points. So you can see here, I'm talking about Premiere Pro. I can click on it and the current time indicator jumps forward to that marker. Now, one of the most popular features when it comes to using transcriptions inside Premiere Pro is text-based editing. This came out within the last year or so, so you can actually, you know, use this text panel to actually edit your videos, which is really cool. If you do want to explore text-based editing, I did make another video going over it, but what I do recommend if you do go down that road to edit your videos is to switch your workspace to text-based editing. Typically, I do leave it in text-based editing regardless whether I'm creating subtitles or doing text-based editing. I just find having the text panel longular in its own panel here very nice and accessible. But just to show you some of the features, say if I wanted to delete this part of the video, what I can do is just make a selection here, and you'll notice that in and out markers are selected in my timeline. If we click on our timeline and zoom in, you can see that in and out markers are created when I highlight different areas inside the text panel. So say if I didn't want this section anymore, I can easily highlight it and then click the extract button, and that will delete it from my sequence here. A few other tools you can explore is this filters button. When you click on it, you can filter words, which is really nice if you want to find certain words. You can also delete all pauses. So say if you do a lot of pauses in your video, you can click on pauses. You can see all the pauses that pop up. You can then click delete. Once you click delete, you can click delete all, and this will delete all of them. It's also worth pointing out that you do have some other filter options. So when you click on the filter and go to search settings, you have a different options here to filter down the minimum pause length and different options here. So if you wanted to cut out shorter pauses, you just drag this to the left and you'll see that more pauses are selected here. But that's text-based editing. The most common next step is, say once you have your edit selected, maybe you want to proof the captions before you actually create them, like make spelling corrections, grammatical errors, make sure that everything's looking nice. Now you'll notice currently, if we look at the text panel, it's pretty staggered. You can see like this line, for example, is seconds or so. you know, and it's very difficult to like, you know, double click and make changes in here. It'd be nice if it was in longer parts or paragraphs, essentially. And the reason this happens is, in theory, Premiere Pro is reading your audio clip. So it's recognizing what's before and after that clip. So say if you want to start spell checking and correcting your captions, what I do recommend is completing your edit first. So for example here, this is a completed video in my timeline here. Export it out and re-import it back inside Premiere Pro. So just to show you, I would go to export, export this out as its own video here. We'll just go into downloads, click save, export it out, and then say back in our window here, we can then import that completed video. So I'm just gonna go and import that and then click and drag this to the new sequence item button here. And then when Premiere Pro automatically transcribes it, you'll notice that it's in longer paragraphs here, which is really nice because what Premiere Pro is doing is it's reading this whole video or audio clip as its own thing. It's not referencing all the things that you cut out when you edited your video. So I do recommend doing this or trying this. This might not work all of the time. If you want to spell check and make corrections to your captions, this is an easier way to kind of work with all of the text. It kind of consolidates it a lot. And you'll notice that it just flows a lot better, the text itself. So the next step would be to go in here and then spell check, make corrections if there's errors in the spelling or the grammar. And then once you're done, then you can create your captions. So let's first talk about how to create closed captions for maybe YouTube or different streaming platforms. To do that, you'll see that at the top there is this CC button. So to create captions, once you're done spell checking and making corrections, you'll just click on the CC button and you'll see this create captions dialog box appear. For broadcasts or for streaming, I typically click on the dropdown and choose either 608 or 708. The CEA-608 is for analog. It's a more of a traditional format, and then 708 is a little bit more updated for digital. Now, it is important to realize that 708 might not be supported on your streaming destination. So 608 is a good way to go if you want it to be supported everywhere. But typically for YouTube, I do select 708 because I know it's supported by YouTube. So either one, if you want to be safe, you can do 608, it's fine. But 708 is kind of newer, and that's kind of the difference between the two. Those are the two standards that I would choose for broadcast or for streaming closed caption creation. But typically I'll choose 708, and I don't really go into the caption preferences that much. I kind of ignore that, and I just create the default by clicking on Create Captions. All right, so once it's finished, you should see all your captions appear, and you'll notice that there's a Captions tab here. You can always go back to the transcript by going to the left here if you need to make changes. But once the captions are made, you'll see this Captions tab appear, and you'll see your captions labeled out here and all as well. If we go out forward in our sequence here, you can see displayed down below is our captions. And what's nice is using this preset, the broadcast standard here, it's already set up so you don't have to worry about characters or making sure that you're having enough text on screen so people can read it. It's a standard, so you know, following this, you should be good for closed captions. If you need to make adjustments, you can always double click either in the program monitor or you can double click here inside the caption itself, inside the text panel, and make adjustments in here if you notice more errors and different things like that. So that's how to create captions. Now to export this, there's a few different ways. So for YouTube specifically, you can export this out as a SRT file, essentially a sidecar file that you can then upload when you go to upload your video. So to do that, what you can do is go to the ellipses, you'll notice this export section, and then right here you can go to export to SRT file, and then you can choose where to save it. For example, you can save it in here. You can see I already exported the SRT file, and then when you're ready, you would go and select this file to upload for YouTube when it asks you to upload for transcriptions or for subtitles. So another common application when it comes to creating subtitles is to create subtitles for vertical videos. Say if you want to post animated subtitles for YouTube Shorts, Instagram Reels, or TikTok, I'm going to show you how to do that next. So following along here, if you already have your text created, spell checked, and all of that, to create closed captions or subtitles for vertical videos, what I recommend is going still to the CC button. This is how you create captions regardless of whether they're subtitles, closed captions, open captions. This is the captions, how to create captions there. But for vertical videos, what I recommend doing is sticking with the subtitle default and then clicking this drop-down button. You'll notice that you have a lot of different options where you can control the maximum length in characters, minimum duration in seconds. So an example here, maybe you want one word captions. Typically, I try to do one word or two of the three words. What I'll usually do is click and drag these sliders to the left, and this will limit how many words or characters are displayed in each caption. And then under lines, you can do single or double. In this case, most commonly, I choose single for vertical videos, and then you can click create captions. And then you can see that all is just like, you know, one word here. And you can see in the text window here, if we scroll down, you can see all the captions are very short, you know, to send them, premiere, you know. So they're very short and snappy, which is very common for vertical videos. Now you can play if you want a little bit more, you can have a few words at a time. It really depends how fast you speak and how much you want to display at one time. But say if you wanted to go this route, what you can do next is stylize them. So to stylize captions, what you can do, I'm gonna zoom in here by clicking the plus button on my computer. And then click on the first caption here. To stylize it, where you'll want to go is into Essential Graphics. So go to Essential Graphics. If you don't see that, you can go up to Window Essential Graphics, and then go to the Edit tab right here. And this is where you can edit your captions. So for example, you can choose a different font. So I'm gonna choose Impact since that's what I usually do for my videos. I'm gonna scale it up a little bit, maybe to 76. And then if we scroll down, you have more options here. If you wanted to add a shadow, it already has a shadow on it, but I'm gonna uncheck that. If you wanted a black background or a different color background to make it pop from the background, you can select that button there. I'm gonna add a stroke, but make it black. So white text with a black stroke. That's typically what I do for my captions, but you can stylize this however you wish. But the most important step here is we're only applying it to one caption. And you'll notice if we go out forward in our timeline, the other ones remain the same. To push the style from this caption to all the other captions on the caption track, where you want to go is at the top of Essential Graphics. You'll notice this little up button. When you click on it, you can push the style attributes to all captions on the track. When you click OK, you'll now notice that when we go forward, the same style is applied to all the captions now. So now they're all there. Now the next step, say if you wanted to animate these, you can't animate them as captions. You'll have to convert them to normal graphic files. And so to do that, what you can do is just marquee select all of them. So I'm gonna marquee select all my captions. And then I'm gonna go up to graphics and titles and click on upgrade caption to graphic. So if we zoom in, these are kind of like normal text files. We can now click on them and we have transform options. We can go into effects controls. You can see we have this vector motion option now where we can change the position, we can keyframe if we wanted to animate our captions. So these kind of convert them into more customizable options for you. But that's how you would create captions for vertical videos, and you would export it baked in to the actual vertical video, and then you would upload it to Instagram, YouTube Shorts, or TikTok. One last thing I wanted to go over in this video was how to burn captions into your video. Now, if you're following along the vertical video, they're already burnt in, they're baked in because they're a graphic file now. But say if you're working with normal caption files, how do you actually burn them and actually make open captions where you can't close them? Where closed captions you can close on the streaming device or on broadcast television, where open captions, they're gonna be open for the whole length of the video, they're burnt into the video. So to do that, we go into our export settings when you're ready to export. So to do that, you go into export at the top left, and then just make sure that all your settings are correct. If you need more guidance on video export settings, I did make a video going over that. I will link that up in the top right corner for you to watch. But for burnt captions, where you'll want to go is under the captions tab. And you'll want to click this on button and then just choose burn captions into video. And you can see the stream format down below. This will burn this caption into the video. But that's captions inside Premiere Pro. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you guys in the next one.